Welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we will look into the questions from the chapter called Probability. Hello friends, may I request you to please click on the subscribe button below this video. The given question is, two dice, one blue and one gray, are thrown at the same time. Write down all the possible outcomes. This is first part of the question. What is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is 8, then second is 13, and the other one is less than or equal to 12. So guys, this question is little bit confusing, otherwise the question is very simple and straightforward. So let us try to learn what is exactly is given in this question. So as per this question, two dice, one blue and one gray, are thrown at the same time. Okay, now, and it also wants to know, write down the possible outcomes. Okay, two dice, one is gray and one is blue. Okay, let's see. Let's say there are two dice. These are two dice. So we very well know there are six faces of a die. So the outcomes will be six. And let's say this is the blue dice. Similarly, if I draw another dice, here the total outcome will be also six, because it has six faces, and let's say it is gray dice. Okay, it doesn't matter which color of the dice it is, but this is what we have. Okay, so one is blue, one is gray, there are two dice, so that is equal to six, and I can write it here as gray, and let me erase this gray one here so that we can do the calculations. Okay, now guys, we very well know that this has blue dice, this has six sides. Any color dice, it has six sides. Here also this has six sides. Because we are very much familiar with the dices, so we know that a dice has six sides. Now write down all the possible outcomes. The question is asking us to write down all the possible outcomes. So let us first of all write down the possible outcomes. Just try to understand this one. So if I draw a line like this, okay, and let's say here I'm going to consider the blue dice, here I'm going to consider the blue dice on this particular, yeah, this is blue dice, and let's say this region is the gray dice. So these are the two dices. This one is the gray dice this side, and this side is the blue dice. Now if these two dices are tossed once, then what is the probability of the outcome? We might get 1 1. In the second chance, we might get 1 2. Similarly, we can get 1 3. So these are the possible outcomes if the dice is thrown, two dices are thrown at a time, and 1 5 and 1 6. Similarly, here 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 2 4, 2 5, and 2 6. Similarly, we will get here 3 1, 4 1, 5 1, 6 1, and here we will get 3 2. 3 3, 3 4, 3 5, 3 6. Here we will get 4 2, 5 2, 6 2. Here we will get 4 3, 5 3, 6 3. Here we will get 4 4, 4 5. And here we'll get 4 6, and here we'll get 5 4 6 4, 5 5 5 6 6 5 6 6. So guys, this is what the question has asked us to write down. So I have written that because the question asked us write down all the possible outcomes. So we have very clearly we have written the all the possible outcomes.
So what did we learn from here? If you look here, the possible outcomes, the total possible outcomes we are getting, total outcomes we are getting is equal to 6 into 6, that is equal to 36. We are getting the total number of possible outcomes, that is equal to 36. And if you count these also, you will be getting 36. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. That means 6 into 6 is nothing but 36. This is what is going to happen if you throw two dices simultaneously. These are the combinations that you might get. Now, as per the question, what is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is 8? Okay. So, coming to the first question, what is the probability that the sum of the two numbers is going to be 8? Before moving on to answer these questions, let me tell you, probability of an event is given by number of favorable events, number of favorable outcomes, upon total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes. Guys, you should always keep this formula in mind so that it will be easy while doing any type of calculation for probability. So if we look here, what is the probability that the two numbers appearing in the top of the dice is 8? So let's see how 8 will come. If you look here, 8 will come like this. We might get 1, 6, if comes 1 and the other one comes 6, it is not possible. Okay, let us look here. In what way we are getting 8? This first row never comes, we will never get an 8. And here in the second row, you will see that we will get 8 here only. And in the second row, we are getting 8 here. In the third row, we are getting 8 here. In the fourth row, we are getting 8 here row here. And in the fifth row, we are getting 8 here, and in the sixth row, we are getting 8 here. So how many 8s we are getting? Combination of 2, 6, 1, 8, combination of 3, 5, combination of 4, 4, combination of 5, 3, and combination of 6, 2. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Altogether, we are getting, means 5 chances or 5 possibilities are there that we will get 8. I believe you understood this. Here, if you add 2 plus 6, we are getting 8, 3 plus 5, we are getting 8, 4 plus 4, we are getting 8, 5 plus 3, we are getting 8, 6 plus 2, we are getting 8. So, altogether, how many chances? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, I can write probability of getting 8, let's say, is equal to number of favorable outcomes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can write 5 upon total number of outcomes. Guys, this is the total number of outcomes, 36. So, just I will include 36. This is one answer, or this is one part. This is the answer for the first part, guys. Now, let us look into the second part. What is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is 13? Guys, do you think that we will get 13? We will never get 13 because the highest number of the two dices are 6 plus 6 is 12. This is the highest number, 6 and 6. We will never get 13. So, I can easily write probability of getting 13 is equal to number of favorable outcomes is 0 because we will never get 13. The maximum number that we can get is 6 plus 6, that is 12. So I can write 0 upon 36. Why 36? Because number of favorable outcomes here is 0, we will never get 13, and the total number of outcomes, that is equal to 0 by 36. So guys, this is the second answer I can say, or I can write it here, probability of getting 13 is equal to 0 by 36. This is the second part. Now let us look into the last part. The last part of the question says, what is the probability that we will get less than or equal to 12? Probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is less than or equal to 12. So guys, you could see from this table or from this calculation, the first one starts with 1, 1, that is 2, and the second one and the last one stops at 6, 6, that is the highest. The total lowest value we are getting 1 plus 1 here, that is 2, and the total highest value that we are getting here, it is 6 plus 6, 12. So everything is included here. That means because the question is asking what is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of this dice is less than or equal to 12. So equal to 12 is this one and less than is everything that is included. So I can write probability of of less than or equal to 12. So I can put it like this: probability of less than or equal to 12 is equal to, as I told you, everything is included, because less than or equal to 12 means everything is included. The highest number is 6 plus 6, 12, and the lowest is 1 plus 1, 2, and everything that falls below highest number is being included. So probability less than or equal to 12 is equal to number of favorable outcomes here is 36, because this is what everything is included means 36 outcomes are included upon total number of outcomes 36. So guys, this is our answer. Just try to understand this last part. The last part of the question is what is the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is less than or equal to 12. So less than or equal to 12, equal to 12 is this 6 plus 6 up to here, and less than means everything that is covered from top to bottom. For that reason, the total number of favorable outcomes here will be 36, and the total number of outcomes is 36. So favorable outcomes is 36 and total number of outcomes is 36. So these are our answers. Hope guys you understood this calculation. This is a little bit confusing, but if you understand or try to understand this dice concept, then everything will be clear. But guys, if you have any questions or doubts, please reach out to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you if I see your comments. Guys, if you really like my videos, please subscribe. If you really like my videos, I would request you to kindly subscribe and also let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.